After Airbus had officially unveiled its brand new A321XLR to the Paris Airshow, there were a lot of boggled minds. I haven't even heard about this A321XLR, and yet it's getting tons and tons of orders. Well, in today's video, I'll be marking out exactly all the aspects about what the A321XLR is, step by step, and why you should be worried about this aircraft if you're a Boeing fan, because it will absolutely kill the 797.
Do remember, guys, I'm doing an exclusive Xbox One X and X-Plane 11 DVD set giveaway. All you need to do is like, subscribe, and comment what your favorite part of the video was. Remember, this giveaway will end on the 31st of July. Airbus touts that the A321XLR brings 30% lower fuel burn per seat than previous generation competitor aircraft, which everyone is guessing refers to the 757. Now, if the Airbus A321XLR already sounds familiar, it's because the aircraft manufacturer was exactly tight-lipped about the introduction of the plane. While this is their formal announcement at the Paris Airshow, they've been talking about this aircraft for several months now, about how they plan on introducing an even longer range version of the A321. This plane will be made markets feasible that otherwise could have never worked in the past. The A321XLR is a lower cost single aisle aircraft that can be used for longer and less heavily traveled routes, many of which just wouldn't be economical with bigger planes. So what are some of the features that this plane has? Following the very positive feedback from the market, Airbus has launched the A321XLR to complement its best-selling A321neo family. The A321XLR thus becomes the next evolutionary step, which responds to market needs for even more range, and creates more value for the airlines by bringing 30% lower fuel burn per seat than previous generation competitor aircraft. Starting from 2023, the aircraft will deliver an unprecedented extra long range of up to 4,700 nautical miles, 15% more than the A321LR, and with the same unbeatable fuel efficiency. With this added range, airlines will be able to operate a lower cost single aisle aircraft on longer and less heavily traveled routes, many of which can now only be served by larger and less efficient wide body aircraft. This will enable operators to open new worldwide routes such as India to Europe or China to Australia, as well as further extending the family's non-stop reach on direct transatlantic flights between continental Europe and the Americas. For passengers, the A321XLR's new airspace cabin will provide the best travel experience while offering seats in all classes with the same high comfort as on long-haul wide-body aircraft.
What do you think about this brand new aircraft? Do you think Airbus should stay with their LR or they should keep going with the XLR? I would love to know your comments down in the section below about what you think this aircraft would be best for.
So how many orders has the XLR received? Well, this has been a huge aircraft lately at the Paris Air Show. It has made tons and tons of orders and it's dubbed to be the next plane of the future. And many people are saying it will be killing the brand new Boeing NMA, or as known as the Boeing 797. But CEO Denise Muhlenberg said it'd be a silly decision to invest so much in an aircraft, saying certainly some interesting comments appearing. There has been 300 plus orders on the aircraft type, and these airlines are added up to be. Airlines have ordered 27, American Airlines have ordered 50, Cebu Pacific Air has ordered 10, as well as FlyNAS, and IAG, or known as International Airlines Group, have ordered 28, Indigo Partners have ordered 50, JetBlue Airways have ordered 13, Middle East Airlines 4, Qantas Group 36, and Saudi 15 in total, making 243. For what we know, Airbus definitely stole at Boeing storm, because essentially Boeing was supposed to present the 797 at the Paris Air Show, but following the Ethiopian Airlines 737 MAX crash and the whole issue, there has been absolutely no time to be launching a new aircraft, especially knowing that they still haven't even launched their 777X only to employees and customers. So, when is the 797 going to be launched? Because customers and the public are extremely curious to see who will perform better, the A321XLR or the 797. In fact, there are so many videos circulating around the internet suggesting that the XLR will dominate the 797. Coming from an honest point of view, I think the XLR will perform better. From the features I've heard, for example, the 4,700 nautical mile range, it is dubbed to be an amazing aircraft, but we still haven't received any new info about this aircraft yet. We don't know if it will have its brand new GE9X engines fitted on the wings, if it will use a different type of engine, is it fuel efficient? All these aspects still haven't been publicly announced by press, as well as the Boeing company. So does this aircraft have any sort of flaws? Despite the announcement of this amazing new aircraft, not everyone is a big fan of narrow-body twin jets flying ever longer distances. So are there any issues with this? Well, one issue may be lower cabin pressure than is comfortable for many flyers. According to Reuters, the A321XLR has a lower cabin pressure than bigger planes like the Boeing 787 Dreamliner or Airbus A350. On the larger planes, the cabin is pressurized to the equivalent of 6,000 feet compared with 8,000 feet for A320 variants like the A321XLR. Travel experts told Reuters that higher altitude setting can contribute to jet lag on long flights like those the A321XLR is designed for, potentially worsening the effect of passing through multiple time zones. Then there's the seating. In a recent middle seat column at the Wall Street Journal, notes that the new Airbus A321XLR could fundamentally change transatlantic flights. Flights could cost less, but at the expense of valuable seat space. It also adds, how long will passengers sit in a small, tightly packed airplane? Soon the answer from it will be longer. Riding in tight quarters in a small plane for 7 hours or more hasn't sat too well with many travelers. Unlike wide body jets, narrow body planes are likelier to offer slim seats and small lavatories with sinks smaller than your dog's water bowl. So what is the future for this amazing airliner? Well, undoubtedly, it's probably going to do a great job in the aviation industry. Also knowing that the 737 MAX is having problems in the industry at the moment. It's also been confirmed by Dennis Mullingberg that the 737 MAX has some autopilot issue. Now, this has nothing to do with the Maneuvering Characteristics Augmentation System, or MCAS. That was actually sorted out a couple of months ago, running more than 200 test flights to get it right. But it is confirmed that there is almost 200 faulty parts involved with this aircraft. 200. That is quite a lot. That is not ensuring the safety for passengers, and this is why a new autopilot issue has actually came up. So, we don't know if the 737 MAX single aisle body aircraft will come back to the industry. So this gives the A321XLR a lot of time to get orders, since the 737 MAX isn't good for customers and airlines will not be wanting to take it. So this is a big downer for Boeing, and if they don't fix their 200 faulty parts sooner or later, they will face a lot of scrutiny by the media, which they have already in fact have, thinking only profit and not passenger safety. So, how many orders will Airbus pull in for their A321XLR in the space of 10 years? Well, already knowing that they've made almost 240 orders, it will definitely pass the cross mark of 1,000 orders of A321XLRs. So their future is really good. But when I mentioned earlier about the flaws with this, jet lag isn't such a good thing for customers, especially frequent flyers. This would actually be bad for the XLR, especially knowing that their cabin pressure is only from 8,000 feet compared to other big aircrafts like the 787. So, keeping this in mind, the A321XLR will succeed, but knowing with extra long range routes, it's not going to appeal most customers or airlines, but knowing from all the features, they will take this anyways.
Remember to give a thumbs up if you 100% know what the A321XLR is. And be sure to comment down below if you think the 797 will kill the A321XLR. Other than this, thank you so much for watching and stay tuned for other Talk Aviation videos as I talk everything about the aviation industry. See you later and goodbye.